If you're looking for a way to back up all of your Microsoft Outlook data, then this video is for you. So here's the process. Click on File in the upper left corner of Outlook, and then choose Open and Export. On the next screen, click on the Import/Export button, and then a window appears. Click on Export to a File and click Next. And make sure here to click on Outlook Data File PST. That's a file that is able to contain all of the Outlook data in its entirety. So we'll select that and click Next. So on this screen, it's asking is what exactly we'd like to export. So in this case, I want to export the whole sample data file that I have. So I'll click at the very top item in the list and make sure that Include Subfolders is selected. Click Next, and now it's asking exactly where to save the file and what to call it. So the easiest way to handle this screen is to simply click the Browse button and choose a location you'd like to save the file. So I'll scroll up in the list on the left here and click on Desktop. And then at the bottom, you can give it a name. So mine's already filled in. It says Outlook Backup Monday, which sounds good to me. Feel free to change yours any way you see fit and click OK. And then click Finish. And here's where it's asking if you want a password on the file. Obviously, this just keeps others out if they try to open your data file and you have a password, they'll have to enter the right password before it shows them any of your sensitive data. But since that's not important to me right now, I'm going to click OK. And now the export process starts. So if your data file is not that large, it'll happen pretty quick, but it could be very, very large and you may have to wait a long time if you have gigabytes of Outlook data. But I can see that the export box just disappeared and it looks like it's good to go. The export is complete. So let's go back to the desktop screen, and yes, there it is. So now we have Outlook Backup Monday, and that is a PST file that has everything that Outlook can include. So that's pretty much it. You can right click and cut or copy that file somewhere else, push it in a folder. You can even transfer it to a new computer and then import that data into your new computer so you don't have to have it stuck on your old machine. If we want to look at the file and make sure that it exported properly, you can go back into Outlook and then click on File at the top left again and then choose Open and Export, and then we want to open Outlook data file. And now it's asking is which file we want to open. So I did save it on the desktop, so let's click on Desktop, and then there it is, Outlook Backup Monday, and I'll double click it. You'll see that a new data file opens here and we can expand the folders, and it does look identical to the one on the top. I see we've got Inbox with 35 unreads, Business with 4, Personal with 5, and that all lines up. So we can be confident that our exported backup file does have all the data that we would think it should. So if you want to disconnect that file from Outlook, you can right click the very top where it says Outlook Data File and then choose Close Outlook Data File. And now it's off the list. So in order to be able to copy or cut that backup file off your drive, you do have to close Outlook after you initially export it. And now this file is portable. Feel free to store it away or make historical archives of different years or even transfer it to your new computer. So that leads me to my next thing, is I'd like to show you how to import this file into Outlook. Before I show you the import process, there are a few things I need to talk to you about concerning Microsoft Outlook. When you open Outlook on a new computer for the first time, you're pretty much forced to enter a live email address and password, and it validates it, adds the account to Outlook, and then it starts downloading the mail that's on the server. So some of the mail you're looking for may automatically just flow right back in, but of course that's only email, it's not the calendar, contacts, notes, tasks, and all the other advanced features of Outlook. So it's very important to be careful in deciding exactly how you want to attach your old data file to Outlook, or if you want to import the contents into the new data file that it just synchronized with the server. I know that's a mouthful, but it'll make more sense in a second. Let's say that this is a new computer and you've already installed Microsoft Outlook and opened it and even entered your email address and password. And the first thing it does, of course, is it downloads any email that's on the server and transfers it into Outlook. So one important thing now is to get the file that you created earlier onto this computer. So here I've got a flash drive that I plugged into the machine, and there's our Outlook Backup Monday file. So we can right click and then copy the file. And then it's good to always put it in a sensible location. So if we scroll up here, I'll click on Documents, and yes, there is an Outlook Files folder already there. So we'll double click that and then right click and click on Paste. So now it's copying the file from the flash drive onto this new computer. And then if we go back to Outlook, remember we'd already configured it, it's already hooked into an email. And for this example, I don't have any data showing up in there, but it actually is connected to a live account. So our choices at this point is, one, would we want to just have that file add on as a secondary set of folders, like the example when I showed how to verify the backup. So if I were to do that, you would simply just click on File, Open and Export, Open Outlook Data File, and then navigate to the file. So actually we're in the right spot, Documents, Outlook Files, there's our Outlook Backup Monday. So we'll just double click it. And then from here, every single thing in that backup file will permanently just stay down there on that second folder list, just like it was before, including contacts, calendar, task notes, all those advanced Outlook features. So that might be all you need, and that's how easy it is to move any PST file from, you know, one place to another place or to a new computer. You basically just open it inside Outlook, you get a separate folder set, and there you go, there's your history. So that's the process of exporting and importing your data in Microsoft Outlook. And this is really useful if you get a new computer and need to move your data over, or if you just like having a historical archive copy just in case you lose something and need to go back in time. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If so, give my video a like, subscribe to my channel, and I plan on making more in the near future. Thanks so much and have a great day.